Today, I'll show you a 2017 American thriller film called Extortion. Spoilers ahead, watch out, and take care. The first scene features a character named Kevin Riley, who is taking a vacation to the Caribbean with his wife, Julie, and son, Andy. While they are leaving the house, their neighbor, Lucas, wishes them the best for their vacation. Andy is very excited and curious about the vacation, and he asks his father several questions. During the flight, Andy asks his father about the Treasure Islands. The family arrives in the Caribbean and begins to enjoy their vacation. Kevin goes to get a jet ski at his son's request, but the list is already full for that day, so he rents a private boat, believing it to be safer, and rides it with his family. They are far from land after a while, so Julia suggests that they return. Andy notices a deserted island and asks his parents to visit it while Kevin turns the boat. Arriving on the island, the father and son decide to walk around, while Julia sits on the beach and reads a book. Kevin and Andy both explore the island before returning to Julia. Following that, they get on their boat to return, but Kevin cannot start it. He tries and fails several times to start the boat. There are no other boats in the area. Kevin is a doctor by profession and does not know automobile engines. As night falls, they are stranded on the deserted island. Julia wakes up the following day to find Kevin attempting to repair the boat. Kevin believes the battery is dead. They're all hungry and thirsty because there's nothing to eat. After all, the island is deserted. Meanwhile, they spot a boat far away and call for assistance, but their voices are not heard. Julia is concerned, considering how to get out of it, but Kevin persuades her, promising he will not let them die there. The next day, they notice Andy's heart is racing because he cannot pump blood adequately. They are concerned, so they stay in the water until someone notices them. Julia remains with Andy in the boat while Kevin steers the boat away from the deserted island. After a while, Kevin becomes tired and falls asleep in the boat. Kevin wakes up the following day and notices a boat. He yells for assistance, and one of the fishermen approaches them. Julia and Andy are unconscious at that point due to dehydration and heat. The fisherman offers them water and inquires as to what transpired. Kevin explains everything to the fisherman and tells him that his son needs to be taken to the hospital right away. The fisherman agrees to assist them in exchange for $1 million in compensation. Kevin counters the price with $40,000 because that is all he has. The fisherman refuses to assist them for $40,000. Kevin is helpless, so he agrees to give them $1 million once they arrive in town. As soon as he agrees to the deal, the fisherman knocks Kevin down with a boat paddle. A few moments later, Kevin regains consciousness and finds himself tied in the fisherman's boat, driven by the fisherman's friend, Jorge. Kevin inquires about his wife and son, to which the fisherman responds, back on the island. The fisherman says they will first go to town, transfer the money, and then return to help Kevin's family. Kevin requests that the fisherman return him to his family, claiming that he will still give him the money. However, the fisherman refuses and drives him to town. The fisherman warns Kevin not to do anything foolish because there are thousands of islands back, and he is the only one to know where Kevin's family is. As soon as they arrive in town, Kevin contacts several of his friends and Lucas from the telephone booth and arranges for the money. He then goes to the bank to transfer the funds into the fisherman's account. The fisherman requests that Kevin follow them in the next boat. The fisherman locks Kevin inside the boat as soon as he steps aboard, claiming that he will notify Kevin when they arrive at the island. Kevin is worried and asks the fisherman to open the door, but the fisherman ignores him. Kevin then follows them because he has no other choice. The fisherman jumps into Kevin's boat in the middle of the sea and begins destroying the boat. Kevin warns him not to do so. He tries to reassure the fisherman that he will not tell anyone about him. The fisherman destroys the boat and drives away, leaving Kevin to drown in the middle of the sea with the boat. Kevin, inside the boat, manages to break the window with a lever and escape. In the meantime, his leg is injured. He swims up and then wraps his t-shirt around his wound. He floats in the sea for a while before being rescued by a random boat. Kevin summons the police in the evening, and Detective Constable Hagen approaches him. Hagen informs him that the U.S. Assembly has been notified and that the U.S. Coast Guard captain will talk him through the rescue plan. The captain estimates that it will take them a week to search the entire sea area. Kevin is furious at the captain because his family will not live much longer. Kevin requests Hagen to catch the phony fishermen who can take them to his family. Hagen responds that it's not a good idea because they don't know who that man is. Hagen also questions Kevin's credibility because he rented the boat far from the resort, transferred a large sum of money to an unknown account, and accompanied a mysterious boatman. On the other hand, Hagen asks him to rest in the hotel until they deploy for the search. Kevin returns to his hotel room, recalling the fisherman's words. He thinks for a while and assumes the fisherman must have the buyers. So he rushes to Hagen and asks him to track the fisherman down through his buyer. But Hagen doesn't believe it's the right thing to do. As a result, Kevin hires a taxi and travels where the fishers sell their catch. He gets there, but he doesn't find anything useful. Kevin returns to the taxi, saddened, and notices a laceration on the driver's hand, similar to the fisherman's. He inquires about the wound and the location where he was treated. The driver informs him that only one hospital can treat it and drives him there. When he arrives at the hospital, he tells the doctor everything and inquires about the fisherman's whereabouts. The doctor refuses to reveal any information about the other patient against the rules. Following several requests, the doctor walks out, following him to check the computer for the necessary information. Kevin discovers the fisherman's name is Miguel Caba and his address. He walks over to the fisherman's house, carrying a small surgical knife. He notices a woman sitting with her ailing child. Caba enters the house while Kevin is inquiring about him and Jorge. Kevin requests that Caba transport him back to the island, but Caba declines. Kevin then starts beating him up, and Caba's wife eventually points the crossbow at Kevin. At the same time, Caba's next daughter appears, and Kevin seizes her to blackmail him. Kevin asks that the weapon be put down. Still, Caba accidentally triggers the crossbow, and the arrow penetrates both Caba's daughter and Kevin's stomach, causing Caba's daughter to die and Kevin to be injured. Caba, enraged, attempts to hurt Kevin, but in self-defense, Kevin stabs Caba with a surgical knife, knocking him unconscious. Kevin regains consciousness and finds himself in a hospital with a handcuff around his wrist. Hagen approaches him and accuses him of hiring the fisherman to murder his family and kill the fisherman and his daughter. Brian Sweeney, the deputy chief of the mission at the U.S. Embassy, also arrives and informs Kevin that the case is no longer a missing person investigation, but a homicide. He also informs him that the search for his family has been halted. Kevin is enraged by the police, so he snatches a gun from one of them and orders him to be uncuffed. He then flees the hospital. He inquires about Caba's boat, but he receives no helpful information. Kevin then comes up with an idea and dials Brian's number from the telephone booth. He instructs Brian to locate Jorge's phone and bring him to the main square along with a translator in exchange for Kevin's surrender. Brian agrees to do it. Later, Kevin notices Hagen in the main square with several police officers, but no sign of Jorge. He then goes to the phone booth and dials Hagen's number. Hagen attempts to persuade him to surrender, claiming that he believes him and there is no other way out. On the other hand, Kevin ignores Hagen and walks away, catching a bus. Inside the bus, Kevin notices Jorge and calls him. Jorge jumps out of the bus and begins fleeing as soon as he sees Kevin. Kevin follows him, manages to stop him, and asks him to tell him about the island where his family is stranded. Jorge is approaching Kevin when he is suddenly knocked down by the truck, seriously injuring him. Despite this, Jorge points out the location on the map where Kevin's family is stranded. Kevin then pulls the gun on some people and forcibly takes their double-engine speedboat. One person complains to the Harbor Patrol about it. The Harbor Patrol notices him and follows him while he fills the gas tank in his boat. As a result, Kevin starts to flee. Kevin ignores the Harbor Patrol's repeated warnings. The Harbor Patrol then begins shooting at Kevin. Kevin starts the second engine, which causes the boat to speed up and escape the Harbor Patrol. A few hours later, he arrives on the island and calls his wife loudly. He follows the footprints and comes across his wife and son, lying down unconscious. He checks and discovers that his wife is still alive and gives her some water. He rushes over to his son and performs CPR. Kevin feels relieved when Andy begins to breathe again a few moments later. He first carries his son to the boat before returning to take his wife. He loses consciousness while carrying his wife to the boat, and both collapse on the beach. After a while, a helicopter arrives and spots them. And here, the movie comes to an end. For more unique and fascinating movies that you may not even have heard about, click on the videos on your screen. Also, do subscribe, like, and comment. Your one act will make a huge difference to us.